Hi, this is Travis with POSGuys.com. We got an Ask the POS Guys question about attendance tracking. So generally when you're doing attendance tracking, you're going to have something like this. You're going to have a set of labels or cards or tags, and it's going to have some kind of number on it and then a name. So in this case, in the sample, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and of course, the first name. So all that is a number. When you scan the barcode, you just have a number. So generally, people like to look up information when they scan a barcode. So normally, you tie into a database. Here, I have access, and I've set up a very simple database. We have a users table, and in the users table, we have a scan ID, which is the 1234 there. It has the first name, last name, phone, address, city, other data. And then I have a scans table. So in the scans table, the scan ID and then a timestamp. So basically you scan into this table, record all your scans, and it cross-references the users table and gets the information on it. Then you either create a form, it'll look something like this where your scan ID goes into here and then it'll look up the people's information over here. Or you can create a web form or an app. But in any case, you have a database that relates the number that you're trying to scan in into the information that you're trying to look up. So that's normally how barcodes work. One alternative to doing a database lookup if your resources are limited is to use the power of a 2D barcode. So in this example, I've taken a 2D barcode and I've expanded upon the number. So instead of including just a number, I've actually embedded the name of the person that's scanning. So if we take a look at this barcode, so basically we're saying first, last, 1, 2, 3, and then a number. So I can change this instead to be 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it would match. So the data on this barcode now is first, last, 1, 2, 3, street, and then the number. Between each one of these fields, I put in a comma. So the comma is the important part, because what we're going to do here is we're actually going to scan into just plain old Notepad. So I have basically Notepad here, and we're going to scan and we're going to create what's called a CSV or comma separated value document. So I'll take my 2D barcode scanner and I'll scan. So if you have multiple barcodes, you know, each time the barcode comes in, you get a scan. And then you have first name, last name, there's a street, and then here's the code that we're looking for. You then save this document as a CSV. So I'll go to save, and I'll go to my desktop, and I'll save it as scans2.csv. Okay. You can then open up Excel, and then I'll go to open, and then I will go to my desktop and scans to CSV, and I'll open it up. And then because you used a comma to divide each one of those cells, there's the information. So you've captured the information like you wanted to see on the screen. You've captured the number. But you didn't tie into a database. You just scanned into a plain text field, saved in the correct format, and now you're able to open it up in Excel and take a look at who came in and who didn't. Also, while you're in the middle of doing your scanning, you can see in Notepad or TextPad the information that is in that barcode. So there's basically two alternatives to looking up database information, either one using a database like Access or a website, or encoding the information into a 2D barcode. The first way, using Access, you only need a 1D barcode scanner, so a less expensive scanner. using a 2D barcode, you'll need a more expensive 2D scanner. And if you get a 2D scanner that has some advanced data formatting that can parse a driver's license, you can get a little fancier and you can skip the notepad step and you can scan straight into Excel and you just program a rule that every time it picks up a piece of information, it sends a tab between the information. So those are some alternatives and a good way to do attendance tracking. For more information on 2D barcodes and barcode scanners, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thanks.